Hey friends, Ash here with GentsScents. Hope you're doing really well. Today I'm going to be talking to you guys about five different blind buys that I made that I don't regret at all. Now this is a tag video, and I actually saw this on Carolina Fragrance Review's channel, so go ahead and check him out. I'll leave a link in the description below to his channel. And originally it was three fragrances that you blind bought and didn't regret, but I have blind bought, I don't even know how many of these fragrances. I don't want to think about it. So I figured I'll bump it up to five. Realistically, I could probably do 100 blind buy fragrances that I don't regret, and probably 100 I do. So let's go ahead and jump into this. Five different fragrances that I blind bought that I don't regret. Now with this video, I could have just hammered home a lot of the fragrances that I've talked about in the past, ones that you already know that I love, things like Halloween Man X or Armani Code Absolue, but I wanted to put in some fragrances here that I don't talk about quite as much. And actually one fragrance that I've mentioned a lot, but whatever. I'll just get that one out of the way first. It's this one, Pure Excess from Paco Rabanne. When this fragrance was first announced, I didn't really have high hopes for it, and a lot of you out there didn't either. And that's because the advertising for this was a little bit on the cheesy side, you could say. But really, when we're talking about fragrances and you say that the advertising is cheesy, you're probably talking about 99% of fragrances. I don't know what it is, but when it comes time to do a fragrance commercial or a fragrance ad, the stupidest stuff possible seems to get put on screen or in print. Either way, the advertising for Pure Excess was on the cheesy side, and Paco Rabanne is a house that seems to be hit or miss. Sometimes their fragrances work great for a lot of people, and other times they just kind of fall flat. This one is a little bit divisive. If you look it up online, some people don't really like it, but I fell in love with this stuff, and over time, I've actually grown to like it more and more. This one has myrrh, vanilla, sugar, liquor, and ginger as some of the notes in the fragrance. And this one has a really nice, enticing, almost vanilla Coke or vanilla cola vibe when you first spray it on. It's got this effervescence to it along with a good amount of sweetness. This one's a little bit divisive. Some people still to this day don't really like it a whole lot, and other people absolutely love it, and I am in that camp. I liked it a lot initially, but over time it grew on me more and more and more. It's a fantastic evening fragrance, fantastic night out fragrance. It does have that sweetness to draw attention, to get compliments. It's got a good amount of depth as well, and it's one of my favorite Paco Rabanne fragrances, period. The next fragrance is really different from Pure Excess. It's this one, Guerlain Louis. Now this retails for $185 for a 50 ml size bottle, which is the only size it comes in, this one right here. I got this from Decants for about $65. Actually, as soon as I saw it pop up at that price, I scooped it up. I thought, man, that's gonna sell out quick. This is the best price I will ever find this fragrance at. And it's still available for that price at Decants. So apparently this one is gonna be at Decants for that price for give or take a month or two, forever. Now I'm just playing. Obviously, eventually it will sell out at Decants, but I thought it was gonna be gone so fast, and it's still available at that price, so shows what I know. This one has clove, benzoin, vanilla, smoke, and carnation as some of the notes in the fragrance. This one is very complex. It's made to be a unisex fragrance, but for me, it does lean ever so slightly masculine. It's resinous, it's sweet, it's deep, it's got a touch of smoke, a little bit of florals in there as well, obviously with the carnation. The one thing that I would point out, and I did mention this in the notes, is the clove. If you don't like clove in fragrances, this one may not be for you because that's one of the main things that I pull from the scent. This one is fantastically unique. I absolutely love the scent. Maybe I don't wear it a whole heck of a lot, but being able to scoop this up for the price that I did, this was a smash hit of a blind buy. Next up is a fragrance from my most recent batch of blind buys. I wanted to go ahead and include one of those. It is Aqua Colonia Intense Wakening Woods of Scandinavia. Yeah, that's quite a name. This is from 4711, which is most well known for 4711, which smells a little bit similar to Neroli Portofino, costs next to nothing, but it is an eau de cologne, and will last you probably 45 minutes before it's completely gone. This has fig, bergamot, pink pepper, coriander, and rose as some of the notes in the fragrance. I got the little 50 ml bottle. It was between this or 250 milliliters. Those were the only two options. 50? 250. So I thought to myself, I will never ever use 250 milliliters of this fragrance. I'll just get the little tiny one. Now this one draws some comparisons to Terre d'Hermès from some people. I don't really get that a whole lot. Now maybe you could say it's kind of like Terre d'Hermès if you modernized it greatly, had it smell more of an aroma chemical kind of way. And I don't mean that negatively, just with this very sparkly sort of poppy way that this comes across as compared to the more luxurious, realistic smelling Terre d'Hermès. Yeah, maybe that's not the best way to describe this because that doesn't make it sound very good, but it actually is. It's fresh, it's uplifting. The rose here is very bright, not at all jammy or dense or powdery whatsoever. Basically, it's a modern woodsy scent with a bunch of fresh spice and some nice florals interwoven throughout. Springtime, summertime, daytime, fantastic scent. And the longevity here and the projection as well, better than you might expect from a fragrance coming from 4711. Officially, they say that this is a cologne intense, but that's not to be confused with an eau de cologne concentration. More realistically, this is an eau de toilette, I would imagine. And also that name, Wakening Woods of Scandinavia. Can't go wrong with that. That sounds pretty cool, at least in my opinion. Next up, we've got one from Mimmo Paris. Not African leather though, Italian leather. This one has tomato leaf as one of the main notes in the fragrance, and that's what sets it apart from basically every other leather fragrance I have. There's also vanilla in here, there's galbanum as well. So you've got some sweetness. It does have a green touch to it, a slight bit of herbaceousness. It smells really interesting to me, very inviting. It's a great springtime fragrance, a great fall time fragrance. And this is the second leather fragrance that I bought in this line after African leather. Now, African leather I sampled first and I loved it. So I bought that as soon as I could. Then I wanted to start checking out the other fragrances in the line. And tomato leaf is a note that I personally really like. Doesn't get used very often, and that makes sense because it's not really the most mass appealing thing on earth. You know, Dior Sauvage was made with citrus and pepper and ambroxan, not tomato leaf. Maybe not the greatest example ever, but you get what I'm saying. It's not something where people smell it and they go, oh my God, is that tomato leaf? That smells amazing. Actually, that's probably what I would say because I'm weird. Everybody else, they would not say that. Anyway, all of that is just to say, I like tomato leaf. I like the note. And the way it's used in here with the leather is fan-freaking-tastic. Like a lot of fragrances in the Mimmo line, sure, it's a little bit divisive, but for me, this was a hit. Absolutely fell in love with it the first time I smelled it. And I'll tell you, if that fragrance was not good, if I didn't like it, I probably would have stopped right there with the leather line. I would have been like, nah, Mimmo, you did good with African leather, but this one, oof, not good. But because I liked that one so much along with African leather, I ended up going and buying pretty much all the other fragrances in the line. So good job, Mimmo, you got all my money. Good for you. Now this last fragrance is one of the few fragrances in my whole collection that my wife can pick up from the smell pretty much right away. There are a whole bunch of scents where she'll go, oh yeah, yeah, that smells familiar. I think I've smelled that before. But there aren't very many where she can smell it and pretty much right away go, oh, I know what that is. And it's this one, believe it or not, Mugler Cologne Fly Away. And I gotta tell you guys something, this should have been in my summer top 10 list for this year. Yeah, screwed that up. For some reason, it completely slipped my mind. And after I was already completely done with the video, I realized I forgot this one. So as of right now, we'll just say this is an honorable mention for my summer top 10. No breakdown here, pretty simple. Grapefruit, cannabis. Now, a lot of times I will bust on fragrances for having a note breakdown that's just three notes, one in the top, one in the mid, one in the base. I think that is so lazy and boring. And yet here, I'm giving this fragrance a pass. They're pretty much telling you, hey, this is really simple. this is what the fragrance does, and it does it well, and if you don't like it, go buy something else. The grapefruit here is fantastic, absolutely fantastic. My wife is in love with the opening of this scent. It's rindy, it's a little bit green, it's bright, it's fresh, it pops, it sparkles off your skin. It is great. The cannabis note in here, does it really smell like cannabis? Nah, not really, but it gives an interesting green tinge to the scent. And as far as summertime, daytime, casual fragrances, absolutely love this fragrance. So with that one, I was looking to pick up one of the new Mugler cologne releases. I had only smelled the original, and I thought that one might be interesting, and it exceeded my expectations. So Mugler cologne, fly away, last one in this list. So there we go, 5 blind buys that I don't regret purchasing. I'll also go ahead and tag Studio Scents to keep this thing going, and I'll link him in the description below along with Carolina Fragrance Reviews. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today. Thanks for all your support. Stay safe out there. See you guys tomorrow with another fragrance video. See you guys.